All right, after that intense segment, let's talk cricket, long to cricket now. West Indies will hope to seal their first ODI series win against England since 2007 when they face off in the second of their three-match series on Wednesday at the Sir Vivian Richards Stadium in Antigua and Barbuda. The Windies have a 1-0 advantage heading into the game after winning the first match on Sunday by 4 wickets at the same venue. Captain Shea Hope is keen on securing the series win on Wednesday.
Like I said, anytime you cross the line, you have to. Main focus has to be to win. Every time you play cricket games for West Indies, it's so much more than just development. Yes, it's a big thing for us, especially now in this particular situation that we're faced with. But as I said, we won up in the series. We got a great chance to win the series on this year. So the main focus.
Yeah, the West Indies captain, Shea Hope, they are joining us via Zoom to preview the encounter. Cricket analyst Fazir Mohammed. Faz, it's great to have you back. First of all, I want to get your opinion on how good you thought the West Indies were in the first ODI on Sunday and whether you think they can have a repeat performance or even get better in tomorrow's second ODI.
I thought it was an excellent performance, and hopefully my audio is a lot better than what we heard from Shea Hope just a little while ago with all that wind in the background at the Sir Vivian Richards Stadium. But however you slice it or dice it, chasing 326, a two-pace pitch, 5 wickets down for 200 and change. Shea Hope going along at the pace that we know him capable of doing, but waiting for the acceleration and still winning with an over to spare. A tremendous performance overall. And it really sets the stage for that second match tomorrow. And yes, you can argue that England, with a lot of their key players rested, a very inexperienced bowling attack, with the exception of Sam Curran, who went for nearly 100 runs. But really, for both teams, this is part of a process. And I think this is what we need to recognize, that if you can make winning a habit, as I'm sure Hope was alluding to, looking to make it 2-0 to clinch the series. Yes, it's important. Winning a series is important because you play to win. A first one-day series victory over England since 2007 is on the cards. But more importantly, you want to develop those skills, those habits, that, to use that familiar phrase, that muscle memory that takes you over the line more often than not, because the West Indies have a long way to go because they're not going to be in the Champions Trophy in 2025. They have to ensure that they can qualify for 2027, which may not be as straightforward as many people think. So yes, in summation, that performance on Sunday was excellent, but it's just one win to start the process.
Yeah, very much the case, Faz. I want to talk about Romario Shepherd. I spoke about him during the Caribbean Premier League because I saw something in him then that I'm not sure I had seen before. And I said to myself, Romario Shepherd could be a real difference maker for West Indies limited overs teams and the type of success we have going forward. And his performance on Sunday again, quite brilliant, especially with the bat and the innings that he played. And today I was thinking about it and I thought to myself, could Romario Shepherd be the West Indies' own Lance Klusner type player?
He could, but he has to be more consistent. That's the bottom line. Ricardo and Mariah, when we're talking about West Indies moving forward, it's all well and good to have one fantastic match, one fantastic performance. And indeed, you could argue that, and Shea Hope alluded to it, not to maybe in a straightforward manner, but talked about Romario Shepherd, his value to the team. You could argue that Romario Shepherd was more man of the match, given his intervention and the acceleration that he brought to the West Indies effort and therefore paved the way for Shea Hope, taking nothing away from the captain. When you get 100 and you win it in the end, 3 sixes to clinch the match, you're obviously going to be at the head of the queue. But 2 wickets and his contribution with the bat, and yes, there will be moments of luck. I don't think England bowled particularly well, but again, you have a situation where Romario Shepherd showed what he is capable of. We need to see that more often than not. Not one match on Sunday and then don't see much again for another 2 or 3 matches. That is not what is required. You need to see a level of consistent excellence if you want to build towards not just qualifying for a World Cup, but once again being a force to reckon with on the international stage.
And Faz, we have to also recognize the contributions of the openers. Alec Athanase in particular is one that I felt as if, you know, he made the job a bit easier for Shehope when he got into bat. Because for me, and we've always spoken about that, once you have a good opening partnership, it's easier to build on that. And for me, it feels really good to talk about that, to be sitting here and discussing that, you know, we had a good opening partnership and it gave the batters to come an easier job. Now, don't get me wrong, it was still a lot of runs to get, but still you had something to build on.
Yes, it was a good platform. Anytime you can get an opening stand of 104, that's good. But what's important, Mariah, is to understand the rate of scoring as well. And also for those two at the top of the order to carry on. I think Alec Athanase is too much of a good player to settle with 50-something or 60-something. I think he has that ability, that innate touch. If you watch him, they're playing to the onside, especially the ball just kisses the face of the bat, playing it through the onside. You can see the hand-eye coordination. Yes, it took Brandon King a while to get going. He might be out of touch a bit, but when he's on song, he's a delight to behold. But it is not good enough. If we're talking about taking on the Australians of this world, South Africa and their bowling attack, India and their bowling attack, to just get to 50-50 odd and give it away, or play a poor shot, or lose concentration. We saw that from Alec Athanase in the regional Super 50 in the early exchanges when his team, the Windies, were taking on Guyana. He was leading the way, blazing away, and then just gave it away with a poor shot, and the Windies lost the match. So again, bringing it to the higher level, for someone of his talent, you've got to be able to capitalize. You've got to be able to say, look, whether it's Athanase, whether it's Brandon King, whether it's anyone else, when you have an opportunity to really turn the screws, you do so for your team first and foremost, but also for yourself, because you develop that habit of getting the big scores and not being satisfied with just over 50.
Right, and Faz, you know, we're still hoping that we can get a big score from Shimron Hetmyer, but I'll leave that discussion for today and just touch on quickly with the time that we have left. The misfields that we saw, in particular from Gurikesh Moti. Faz, for me, you know, in the second ODI, we're hoping that, you know, that word that you just used, concentration, that the players can, you know, despite how difficult it gets, because, I mean, being out there in the field for quite some time is very difficult, but can keep that concentration and ensure that we don't have those misfields, because I think it really comes back to haunt us as the runs pile on.
Well, Mariah, I appreciate your sympathy for the West Indies team, but I have no sympathy for players who make fundamental mistakes, because it's 3.5 hours. Yes, it might be boiling hot sun, whatever it is, but it's the same for everybody else. So the fact of the matter is that if we want, as the West Indies, to get back up to the highest level, because we're not, we are at the lower reaches right now. Let's face that. We couldn't qualify for the last World Cup. You can dance around it how much you want. That's a fact, and that's a historical fact. If you want to get back up to the highest level, you have to do so with consistent excellence, not once in a while excellence. And that includes feeling. In fact, more than anything else, it includes feeling. When West Indies won the first World Cup in 1975, the great Vivian Richards starred in the match, not with the bat, not with the ball, but effecting 3 runouts. So again, it brings home the point that fielding should be a non-negotiable. Fitness should be a non-negotiable. There may be many other variables, but these things surely should not be a discussion point when we're talking about West Indies cricket moving forward.
Yeah, well, you know what, Faz? Unlike Mariah, I can't dance, so I am very much with you on that point. Thanks very much, Faz. We'll be catching up again soon following Wednesday's second one-day international. Take care.
Take care. I'll leave you to deal with that quizzical look from Mariah.
Oh, no. Why me?